Hey everybody, this video is strictly pretty much going to be informational. It's all stuff I found in the Wikipedia, a little bit in the Strong's Concordance, stuff like that. I started this research a couple weeks ago. I was just curious as to how we got the translation of the Bible. I mean, how it got from Hebrew, Greek, Aramaic to the modern day English that we speak. And as I started doing the research, it just kept getting kind of deeper and deeper. And so I wanted to share this information with everybody, and some of you may already know this and some may not. So I just wanted to get it out there. When I first started researching, I came across the Masoretic text. And out of the Wikipedia, it says the Masoretic text is a Hebrew text of the Jewish Bible. The Masoretic text is also widely used as the basis for translation of the Old Testament and in recent years also for the Bible. It says the Masoretic text was primarily copied, edited, and distributed by a group of Jews known as the Masoretes. So I looked up Masoretes, and it says they were a group of scribes and Bible scholars working between the 7th and 11th centuries. So basically, the Bibles that we have today are translated from this Masoretic text that was copied, edited, and distributed by the Jewish Masoretes. And so I thought, okay, that sentence just kind of stuck out to me. Copied, edited, and distributed. Now I think of it like this. Let's say you work for a newspaper, you write an article. Now before they print it and distribute it, you have to take that article to the editor, and the editor's gonna, you know, look over it and read it, say, change this, take this out, put this in, you know, something like that. And basically that's what they did to the original scrolls. They edited them. So then I asked myself, okay, if these Jewish people can come in, take someone else's land, and set themselves up as God's chosen people, obviously they're going to have to hide something, change something. They're going to have to do something so that people don't find out the truth. I found under that Masoretic text, it says, the discovery of the Dead Sea Scrolls dating from 150 BC to AD 75 show numerous small variations, both as against the later Masoretic text and between each other. It is also evident from the notings of corrections and of variant alternatives that scribes felt free to choose according to their personal taste and discretion between different readings. So it shows that the original scrolls vary from this Masoretic text, and that these Jewish Masoretes, they use their own personal feelings, basically, on what to put in there. Now, it also says, under the category fixing of the text, since no additions were allowed to be made to the official text of the Bible, the early Masoretes adopted other expedients. Example, they marked the various divisions of spacing and gave indications of halakhic and Haggadic, and I'm probably not saying those words right, teachings by full or defective spelling, abnormal forms of letters, dots, and other signs. Now, I don't know a lot about Hebrew, but I do know that the slightest little dot or dash or comma can change a word, and therefore it's going to change the meaning of that word. It also says that early rabbinic sources from around AD 200 mention several passages of scripture in which the conclusion is inevitable that the ancient reading must have differed from that of the present text. So there's proof that the original sea scrolls that they found differ from the Masoretic text. Now, here is where it really started getting interesting. At the end of that article, it says, among the rejected books by both the Judaic and Catholic canons was found the Book of Enoch, the Manual of Discipline, and the War of the Sons of Light against the Sons of Darkness. I instantly thought to myself, now, Why would they reject these books unless there's something in there that they want to keep hidden? So in the Wikipedia, under the Sons of Light against the Sons of Darkness, it says that it is a manual for military organization and strategy that was discovered among the Dead Sea Scrolls. These scrolls contain an apocalyptic prophecy of a war between the Sons of Light and the Sons of Darkness. In the end, all of darkness is to be destroyed, and light will live in peace for all eternity. The war is then described as a conflict between the congregation of God and the congregation of men. The rest of the document is a detailed description of the events of the war and the ways in which it should be conducted. So it's pretty obvious when you read that why they didn't want that in there. You know, they don't want the Sons of Light to know anything about this war or how it should be conducted. Now, I also looked up the Book of Enoch. And I'm just going to go through the content a little bit. There's 21 pages to it, so I don't want to read all of it. But there's 5 sections to this book. And as I go through this context, you're going to know, it's going to be pretty obvious why the Jews and the Catholics rejected this. The first section is the Book of Watchers. It has a parable of Enoch on the future lot of the wicked and the righteous, the fall of the angels, the demoralization of mankind, the intercession of the angels on behalf of mankind, the dooms pronounced by God on the angels of the Messianic Kingdom. The first section depicts the interaction of the fallen angels with mankind. Simeos, and I'm probably not saying that right either, compels the other 199 fallen angels to take human wives in order to have children. Says the result is the creation of the Nephilim, or Anak, which means giants. It also discusses the teaching of humans by the fallen angels. So these angels were teaching them. It says they taught men to make swords, knives, shields, breastplates, and made known to them, the metals of the earth and the art of working them, bracelets, ornaments, the beautifying of the eyelids, and all kinds of costly stones and all coloring tinctures. And there arose much godlessness. They committed fornication, they were led astray, and became corrupt in all their ways. They taught enchantments and root cuttings, the resolving of enchantments, astrology, the constellations, the knowledge of the clouds, the signs of the earth, of the sun, and of the moon. So basically, these fallen angels that had came down here and had children with the women of the earth, they were teaching the men all about this kind of stuff, because obviously they didn't know anything about it prior to that. Now the second section is entitled Book of Parables. It says the Book of Parables appears to be based on the Book of Watchers, but it presents a later development of the idea of final judgment, concerned not only with the destiny of the fallen angels, but also of the evil kings of the earth. It has the first parable, which has the coming judgment of the wicked, astronomical secrets, the dwelling places of wisdom and of righteousness, another one on astronomical secrets. The second parable has the lot of the apostates, the new heaven and the new earth, the prayer of the righteous for vengeance and their joy at its coming, the fount of righteousness, the Son of Man, the stay of the righteous and judgment of the kings and the mighty, the glorification and victory of the righteous, the repentance of the Gentiles, the valley of judgment, the angels of punishment, the communities of the elect one, final judgment of Azazel, who was one of the fallen angels, the watchers and their children, last struggle of the heathen powers against Israel. The third parable has angels go off to measure paradise, the judgment of the righteous by the elect one, the praise of the elect one and of God, judgment of the kings and the mighty, blessedness of the righteous.